Good evening. A record number of women and a minister for the Republic. History was made today as Anthony Albanese's new front bench was sworn in. But the occasion came with a warning, the PM telling his ministry they will govern in turbulent economic times and will push for a wage rise for millions of Australians.
It was a family affair at Government House as former ministers and a new generation of Labor leaders gathered before the Governor-General to be sworn in.
I, Donald Edward Farrell.
An oath made for some on Bibles, one on the Torah and, in an historic first, the Quran.
So help me God.
Others made affirmations as the first Labor ministry in 9 years took shape one by one. In the ranks, the first Indigenous woman in Cabinet, Linda Burney, will work on constitutional recognition of the first Australians. She's one of 10 women in the government's inner sanctum, including Victorian Claire O'Neill, who'll take on the massive task of Home Affairs. Jason Clare has been elevated to Education.
I will well and truly serve the Commonwealth of Australia.
The Outer Ministry and Assistant Ministers add another 9 women and a new title, Assistant Minister for the Republic, in Matt Thistlethwaite. Combined, they are a vivid image of change. The full ministry gathered in the cabinet room.
It's a privilege to be here. Cherish every day, make a difference every day.
But this ministry is facing challenging times.
We have economic headwinds, which we're facing.
On the surface, the numbers are good. The quarterly measure of Australia's economic health, the national accounts released today, show despite the floods and the Omicron outbreak, the economy grew strongly over the first 3 months of the year at just under 1%, with the annual pace of growth a respectable 3.3%. That was the recent past, but the Treasurer sees a turbulent present.
Inflation is higher. We've had an interest rate hike. Petrol prices are up 12% since the end of April. Wholesale electricity prices are up 237%.
Add to that a huge spike in gas prices,
which goes hand in hand with a spike in the price of liquid fuels. And a spike in the price of electricity as well.
And the Treasurer has confirmed that the government will petition the Fair Work Commission to lift the minimum wage in line with the rapidly rising cost of living.
It's 5.1% is inflation in the economy right now. Anthony was asked by your colleagues, should the pay rise reflect that number? And we said yes, absolutely, and our submission will reflect that.
The decision will be handed down in July. Chris Yulman, 9 News.